Here we're going to find the slope-intercept form of the equation of a line when we have a line that's parallel or perpendicular to some other line. So for example, let's get rid of that. Let's find the equation in slope-intercept form of the line through the point 1 half negative 1 third perpendicular to the line y equals 2x minus 5. Now, the first thing that jumps out at me is that our line is perpendicular to this line, okay? Now let's write that down. Lines that are perpendicular, so perpendicular lines have slopes that are negative reciprocals. Now that phrase, negative reciprocals, all that means is that you take the reciprocal and then you take the negative. So for example, if you had the number 3/4, what would the negative reciprocal of that be? Well, you take the reciprocal, which is 4/3, and then the negative of that. Okay, so these two numbers are negative reciprocals. Now we're asked to find the equation of a line in slope-intercept form. So we're looking for this, y equals m times x plus b, where m is the slope of our line and b is the y-intercept of our line. Now, this is the other line, right? And this right here, that 2, that's the slope of the other line. But what we said earlier is that because our line is perpendicular to this line, the slope of our line is the negative reciprocal of 2. So the slope is 2 of this line, right? 2 over 1. So our m, well, the negative reciprocal of this would be 1 half, but the negative of that, okay? So I'm going to take this, and that's going to give rise to my slope, which is negative 1 half. And then I have times x plus b, okay? So I used the slope for the other line to get the slope of my line because I knew my line was perpendicular to that other line. Okay, now we want to find b. And we're going to find b by replacing x with 1 half and y with negative 1 third because our line goes through this point. Okay, so y is negative 1 third, so negative 1 half, and x is positive 1 half, and then plus b. So it's going to be negative 1 third is, let's see, negative 1 fourth plus b. And now I'm going to multiply both sides by 12 to clear fractions, 12 over 1. And so the left-hand side is going to be negative 4, and the right-hand side, when I distribute that 12, it's going to be, let's see, negative 3 plus 12b. And now I'm going to add 3 to both sides. So I've got, let's see, it's going to be negative 1 is 12b. Now if I divide both sides by 12, I'm looking at b is equal to negative 1/12. That's my y-intercept, negative 1/12. So now I'm going to take that b and replace b here in my equation. So my answer is this. Y is negative 1/2 times x minus 1/12. That's the slope-intercept form of my line. Okay, let's try another one like that now, except where the line that we're looking for is parallel to some other line. So find the equation in slope-intercept form of the line passing through the point negative 2, negative 3, parallel to the line 2x plus 3y equals 5. Okay, so remember parallel lines. What's true about parallel lines? Well, those lines have the same slope, okay? So what we're going to do is we're going to look at the other line, right? 2x plus 3y equals 5. And even though we're looking for our line, you know, we're looking for y equals mx plus b. Let's write that down, what we're looking for. So once again, we want to find the equation of our line. What we're going to do is we're going to start with the other line and find its slope. Okay, so the other line is 2x plus 3y is equal to 5. Now, how can you find the slope of this line? Well, there are a couple of ways of doing it, but one way is to put this line into slope-intercept form. So I'm going to subtract 2x from both sides, and that's going to give me 3y equals negative 2x plus 5. And now I'm going to divide both sides by 3. So I'm looking at y is equal to negative 2/3 times x plus 5/3. Okay, now this is the slope of the other line. Okay, now the question is, how is my slope, which I'm denoting here as m, related to this slope? And the answer is they're the same, because parallel lines have the same slope. Okay, so I can just take that negative 2/3 and I'm going to plug it in for m. So I get y equals negative 2/3 times x plus b. And now once again, I have to find the b. And I'm going to make use of my coordinates, right? My line goes through this point. So I'm going to replace x with negative 2 and y with negative 3. So I've got negative 3 is, let's see, negative 2/3 times negative 2 plus b. So negative 3 is, okay, negative times a negative is a positive 4/3 plus b. Okay, let's go ahead and multiply both sides of this equation by 3. So write that as 3 over 1, and then 3. 3 times negative 3 is negative 9. And on the right side, I'm going to get, let's see, I distribute the 3 and those cancel, so it's going to be 4 plus 3b. And now I'm going to subtract 4 from both sides. So I've got negative 13 is 3b. Divide now both sides by 3. So b is equal to negative 13 over 3. So b is equal to negative 13/3. Once again, replace b with negative 13/3. So y is equal to negative 2/3 x minus 13/3. And this would be my answer. This is the slope-intercept form of my line. Okay, we're going to see some other forms of lines, other forms of equations of lines soon. But the most important by far is the slope-intercept form like we've been working with. Okay, until next time.